people. Tonight I decided that I'm going to do a simple video on my phone. It's very late at night, and I thought I would show you some things that I do to unwind or relax. I'm a very anxious person. I don't know if that reads all over me, but I'm just gonna show you some things that I think kind of help. I'm not like a medical professional, so take any advice I give with a grain of salt. Keep in mind it is coming from me. So let's just get into the mess. To begin with, I'm sitting on this huge beanbag. Like, it's not even beans though. It's like memory foam. It's from Big Joe. And I don't know what size it is. It's not a beginner's level beanbag. This is probably intermediate to expert level. But it's serious. So I'm just sitting on it. I have a nice plush blanket beneath me, and this definitely adds to the relaxing factor. So let's just get to it. So this first thing I'm going to show you, this little device here, is an aromatherapy steam machine. Vapor machine. Basically, what you do is you fill it with your desired amount of water. And this one has like three little buttons. I don't know if you can see. Here. And it has like, it lights up, and you can pick if you want it to like shoot out very aggressively, or if you want, you know, a little slow. Like it quite aggressive. You can put it for 2 hours to 6 hours, or yeah, I was say just on, but I'm pretty sure it'll just cut out when it reaches to the bottom. So to make the steam smell really good, well, the paper, I don't know why I keep saying steam, you put your essential oils. Now, it does give like a little guide to how much you should use, but rules are for suckers. I just kind of throw in as much as my heart pleases. I treat it like seasoning. So this, you can see, is the new you. And these are the essential oils that I have. I would describe the scents, but they're pretty self-explanatory. I'll go over them with you. Okay. So this first one is one of my favorites, if not my favorite, and it is lemon. It smells like a lemon. Then we have lavender. And we have eucalyptus oil. And we have orange, which is really, really nice. It's very fragrant, and this is one of my favorites as well. Tea tree oil. Pretty sure I put this on a piercing one time in my Monroe piercing. Bad idea. And peppermint. I love the scent. When I smell it come out, I really do like it. It does give me a bit of like a Vietnam War flashback though. And let me explain that. I was gifted a peppermint body wash one year. I was much younger. Not as intelligent as I am now. And I just went buck wild with this body wash. and cranny. I was getting to it. And, oh my god. Never, ever, if I could write a book of life lessons, never put anything menthol near your genitals, ladies and gentlemen. That is, if I can get one thing out into the public, don't do so. I know someone's gonna ask. My shirt says, when I'm feeling a bit down or stressed. I've been doing this for a while. I don't remember where I got the idea. I'm sure someone out there or a lot of people do this. Now, these are little journals. Got the man doing the jumping jacks with his meat out. So, with these journals, what I do, I have regular notebooks where I write things I need to do, grocery lists, things of that nature, ideas. But when I want to write my feelings, I go to a small book like this, and I write what I'm feeling. I'm not going to show you, number one, because my handwriting is really bad, and there's not much in here. These are new. The therapeutic part for me is partly writing it out, but what I do after is I rip out the pages and I burn them. I don't know why I enjoy that. It makes me feel a lot better. If you are going to do it, make sure you do it in a very contained space and don't start a wildfire over your sad notes. But yeah, it makes me feel a lot better. It's kind of cleansing. I don't know if that's odd or if anyone else really does that. If you do that, let me know. But I recommend you trying it. It's very freeing. Thing that can be really relaxing, of course, is reading. Good book. One's called Sugar Run. This one's called Touch. This is a field guide to grief. Notes for the ever lost. This is actually like a book / recipe book. I do have another book upstairs that's kind of funny. Like, I misread it at first. I thought it was like 1,000 recipes of kebab, but it wasn't. It was like 1,000 ways to love kebab or something. But this is from Carla Hall. I love Top Chef. I love Hell's Kitchen. I love anything with Gordon Ramsay. Kitchen Nightmares, 24 Hours, The Hell and Back, Chopped, Cutthroat Kitchen. I love, like, the Food Network and anything having to do with, like, cooking. So, Carla was one of my favorites on Top Chef. And she gave me the call that I use with my family now in the grocery store or something. The Hootie Who call. do tend to read mostly fiction. I don't read many biographies. I don't find them to be something I can sit down and read. As shallow and terrible as this sounds, I love to watch documentaries. Like, I'd rather go that route. My brain absorbs the information better. I don't really read self-help books either, obviously, but I need to. I could probably use that. So yeah, a nice book. It's always really cool and nice to wind down with. Take your mind off of anything that's stressing you. Let's say you're not very much a book person though, because truth be told, sometimes my ass isn't a book person. A nice magazine. Foolproof, easy reading. You don't have to read everything in it, you can skip around. Very low commitment, my kind of thing. So, I literally just got this in the mail today. And it has Christian Siriano on the cover. I'm a huge reality TV buff, like, I love it, okay? I love Jersey Shore, I love Project Runway, and that's where he's from. I've seen every season, I've seen All Stars, I love Heidi Klum, and at the end, I literally just found out, do you know when people get eliminated, she doesn't say, Aufsie Dussie. She says like something in German, I think. But my whole life I was like, Aufsie Dussie, that's so cute. And so I thought that's what she said, but she didn't. Aufsie Dussie. But Christian Siriano's pretty big, actually. He made it big from the show. And I'm not sure if that's necessarily the case for a lot of them. I know there's been a couple of people who didn't even win that got big. I think Michael Costello got a pretty large business. He makes pretty gowns. If you hear any signs of life, I do live in a very, I guess, populated place. I used to live out in like bumfuck Egypt. Magazine. Okay, so this next thing, I have to be completely honest about. I'm not sure if it's relaxing. I could maybe see it being something that can reduce anxiety or something like that, because you'll just be so annoyed with it, if that makes sense. But my mother is a very crafty woman. She likes to actually build miniature towns, like for Christmas. She builds like everything, like out of styrofoam. She carves it out. She makes little rivers and like houses. If I'm ever at her house, I'll have to take a video of it. It's pretty cool. But she gave me, I don't even know how to explain this, but she gave me these like jewel poster things. Anyways, so you get this. I'm kind of wondering if my mom loves me. Like, I don't know if I'm gonna like this, but maybe it could be fun. So she gave me like people papers like that. So the spaces have like numbers on them, and she gave me these like beads, and each of the beads have a number like printed on them, and I have little baggies too. And you, like, it's like painting by numbers, but you place the jewel on. So when you complete a little thing, you have like a flat design, but bejeweled. It's hard to explain. This is like the wax that you use to tack down the jewels. Is this making sense? She explained it to me, but I haven't done it yet. It's honestly kind of intimidating, but I want to try it. So if you guys have any tips, and I'm probably going to need more wax than that itty bitty bit. So I got the wax. I don't know what this is. This is like the pencil-like utensil that you use to grab your jewels and place them. And so it can give you calluses. You can use like a jelly pencil grip. Fits on perfectly. They give you some vinyl cement to seal your project once you're done. So I'm pretty excited to try it. We'll see how it goes. I shouldn't mess it up too bad, right? Now there are some things I like to do that are pretty obvious, self-care kind of things, but they do relax me. These would be like two top things that if I have them going on, I'm probably pretty chill. I love to take steaming hot baths, like scalding hot. I want it to hurt a little bit, and I love a nice bath bomb. This is the ice berry. The other day I used one that was like purple, like this, and it smelled so good. I think it's really important to take time out for yourself. I also like nice exfoliating scrubs, face masks, I'll do those in the bathtub, and when I'm in the bath, my skin, you know, your pores open up, and I'm not gonna include it in this video, but something that does relax me, and it's probably pretty gross, is I like to use my little gunk sucker 3000, and, you know, get shit out of my face. Thing I like is, of course, lotion. It puts the lotion on the skin. Now, my favorite thing to do with lotion is to lather up my feet. And for all you pervs out there wondering, you can buy like feet pictures from me. Answer is yes for the right price. I like to put the lotion on my feet, and then I take my coziest socks and I slide my feet in, and honestly what's best is to sleep in it, and then when you wake up in the morning, oh my god, your feet are like heaven. Little tidbit, I'm sure you could probably do like gloves for your hands or something similar, but it keeps your toesies nice and soft. My sense of smell is something I hold very near and dear to my heart, of course, but it's very important to me because it affects my mood completely. I sometimes will smell things that I associate with a bad memory. It doesn't have to be a bad smell, and it'll make my mood just shit. So, I like to have nice scents around me to help calm me. Like the aromatherapy thing, but I love candles too. But I also have wax melts. They're just cheap ones. But I have vanilla. You was my baby, my fucking cinnamon apple. And wild honeysuckle. And I just put these in my little wax warmer that I have. I think right now I have the honeysuckle in the wax warmer right now. I do have regular candles as well. Now, Bath and Body Works candles are no joke. I open this bitch and like, with not even like lighting it, the room was just like that. It smelled so good. It was like being punched in the face by Christmas, and I love it. And they have a nice 3-wick candle. But my current favorite candle is the Homesick Arizona. Now, this says it's a hand-poured scented candle, and it's made with soy wax, made in small batches in the US of A. Let's see if there's like a... I don't know what scent is supposed to be. I don't think Arizona smells like this, but it'd be nice if it did. Oh, that's good. It smells a little bit like cucumber and a sexy dude, and I have no better way of explaining that, so we're just gonna leave it at that. Now, the next thing that I absolutely love is like getting a hug and feeling all warm from the inside out, and it is tea. I only have 3 different kinds of tea right now besides like your basic blend to make sweet tea, because I always have to have that. But this is the moringa tea. I just finished up a ginger and turmeric tea. It was super fragrant and like bright piss yellow. I loved it. Then I have this green tea. This is original. This is from Aldi. Oh, Aldi. It's super cheap. And this one I've made an absolute dent in is the Tea Craft. This is my favorite. Ginger peach green tea. Better than me just throwing things in a cup, but this tea is really, really good. And I just really like drinking hot tea, preferably, because it's just something that is tied to when I was younger. I would always drink hot tea with my grandma, still do, and it just makes me feel really calm and at ease and very homey. Like to have my nice cup of tea. Okay, you guys, so last but not least, something that makes me feel happy, relaxes me. It's pretty stupid, but it is my favorite snack. It's very simple. You can find it at your super classy Walmart, and it is just regular popcorn, preferably movie theater butter. I also like to pop my own on the stove. this is just good if you want something fast and easy. I can eat popcorn every day, 24/7. It's pretty bad. But it's definitely my favorite snack. But let's say you want to pop popcorn on the stove and you still want that movie theater butter flavor. What do you do? I got you. This. The Orville Redenbacher topping and popping oil. Well, popping and topping. Whatever. Now I'm going to be real with you. I use it for both. If you want to pop your kernels and have a light buttery flavor, you just pop your kernels in this. But if you like the full-fledged cholesterol going up popcorn like me, like takes years off your life popcorn, if you put this on freshly popped popcorn, it tastes just like the movie theater. This, and they have something just like this, the Pop Secret. Of course, it's not butter, it's soybean oil and artificial flavor, and it's colored with beta carotene, so super artificial, not so chemically, so that's nice, but it's delicious, and I highly recommend it. Get it at Walmart. Pretty sure you can get it at most grocery stores and the chip. Okay guys, so that wraps up this video. I hope that you liked it, and hope that maybe it gave you some tips. Probably not, but I hope that maybe it relaxed you, or I just got to keep you company. I hope that you have a good night or a good day wherever you are, and I love you very much. Bye.